If GLP-1 or dexbupropion are not options, what else can decrease inflammation? Well, that's a great question. The best way to decrease inflammation in MDD, at least fit for purpose, is to get a good night's sleep. That's highly anti-inflammatory. Secondly, is to have better diet. But you know, all you need to do is go to the local grocery store. How can you have a better diet and afford what they're selling you, right? Pop-Tarts are much more affordable. So I appreciate that. I appreciate that. So that's an economic issue. But diet clearly, good sleep. The other part is something, a pill that nobody wants, and that's exercise. I know they gag on that pill, but that's one. But also, in fact, weight loss. I know it's not easy without a GLP-1 nowadays. So those are all anti-inflammatory. What else is anti-inflammatory? Mindfulness-based therapy is. CBT is anti-inflammatory. Many of our antidepressants have anti-inflammatory properties, including the atypical antipsychotics. They have anti-inflammatory properties as well. For example, lumateperone, brexpiprazole, and cariprazine all have anti-inflammatory properties. And what's interesting, they all treat anhedonia. Isn't that interesting? So within the pharmacologic space, we have this effect. One other treatment that decreases inflammation that's pharmacologic that we don't think about is 4-deoxytine. It's a COX-1, COX-2 inhibitor. And that's why we developed it for long COVID syndrome, because it does have this anti-inflammatory effect in people with high CRP and living with long COVID. They got brain fog. So there's many modalities of treatment, but stay tuned. We're going to say a lot about GLP-1s and why we think they're going to be an interesting thing to look at in psychiatry.